Have you ever wondered why Daniel faces towards Jerusalem when he prays and why this detail is given? In my sermon this past Sunday, I recounted the story of Daniel in the lion's den, which you can find in Daniel chapter 6. And it tells very specifically that Daniel went three times to the window in his upper room to pray towards Jerusalem, that he offered his petitions and pleas to the God of Israel there in that place. And we have a children's Bible in our house, which has a wonderful picture of this, of Daniel standing in a window with his arms up, looking out towards, I guess, where Jerusalem would be, with onlookers below looking up at him, wondering, what is he doing there? On whose God is he calling? Daniel, as we are told, is known to make his petitions to God three times a day, and this is clearly evident that everybody around him knows this as well, especially his fellow officials. And so why was Daniel facing Jerusalem and making his petitions and prayer? And what were those petitions and prayers? Well, if we look back into Deuteronomy chapters 28 through 30, we'll discover that Moses has a whole list of blessings and curses upon the people of Israel. Blessings for those who are faithful to God's covenant and curses upon those who fail to keep God's covenant. And what we read in chapter 28, verse 64, it says, "And the Lord will scatter you among all peoples, one from one end of the earth to the other," meaning if they do not keep his covenant, this is the final outcome, the culmination of God's curses upon them. And yet this is not where it ends. Actually, there is some good news as well. And that comes a little bit later in chapter 30. And it says 30, chapter verse 1 and continuing, "And when these things have come upon you, the blessings and the curse, which I have set before you, and I call them to mind among the nations where the Lord your God has driven you, and you return to the Lord your God and your children, and obey his voice in all that I have commanded you today with all your heart and with all your soul, then the Lord your God will restore your fortunes and have mercy on you, and he will gather you again from all the peoples where the Lord your God has scattered you." So that is what Daniel is praying and petitioning God for. If you remember, Daniel was an exile. He was one of those that was taken out of the land of Judah and scattered into the Babylonian Empire. And so he's praying for God to do what he said he would promise to do. And so why facing Jerusalem? Well, for this, we need to turn to 1 Kings chapter 8, verses 46 to 53. In this chapter, it's Solomon dedicating to the temple of God to God. He has just finished building it, and this is a part of the inauguration. And he says in his dedication, so this is 8 verse 46, "If they sin against you," that is the Israelites to come, "for there's no one who does not sin, and you are angry with them and you give them into an enemy, so that they are carried away captive to the land of the enemy, far off or near, yet if they turn their hearts in the land to which you have carried them captive, and they repent and plead with you in the land of their captors, saying, 'We have sinned, we have acted perversely and wickedly,' if they repent with all their heart, with all their soul in the land of their enemies who carried them captive, and pray towards their land which you gave to their fathers, this city that you have chosen, and this house that I have built for your name, then hear in heaven your dwelling place." And so there we have it. That is what Daniel is praying for. And that is why Daniel is also facing towards Jerusalem. Because God had given a promise that if they prayed towards Jerusalem and they continued to be faithful, that God would hear their prayer and one day restore them to their land. Israel's unfaithfulness resulted in their exile, but the promise was that through the faithfulness, or the renewed faithfulness, of Israel, God's salvation would come. But for that, the New Testament tells us that Israel has to wait another 400 years until Jesus is born. But that is a different story. And so that concludes this Menno Minute. Have a good day.